What's going on, guys? Baus Phoenix here, and finally, at long last, we are taking a look at the insect glaive, lovingly known in the community as the Weeb Stick. But before we get into that, I wanted to let you know real fast that this video is sponsored by Amino App. If you guys follow my For Honor content, you'll probably have seen me talk about Amino here and there. Put simply, Amino is the very best place to connect with people who share your interests, and they pretty much have a community for any interest you can imagine. Cooking, music, pretty much any video game you could think of, and most relevant to this video is the Monster Hunter Amino community, which is the ultimate destination for Monster Hunter World. Now, as you can see from the live layer here, there's always something going on in the Monster Hunter Amino. You can take quizzes, chat with other members, vote in polls, or do any number of other activities within the community. If you've been in the Monster Hunter community for a while, you know it's filled with people passionate about the game, and the Monster Hunter Amino community is no different. I mean, look at this fan art for Odogaron. And as if that weren't enough, the Amino app also offers tons of social features, including, but not limited to, chat rooms. It's pretty easy to just jump in and start meeting people. Anyway, if you haven't checked out the Monster Hunter Amino community yet, now is the perfect time to join, seeing as Monster Hunter is now more accessible than ever, and as a veteran, the Amino community needs you to show new hunters the ropes, and as someone new to the series, now is the perfect time to hop on Amino and find a hunting partner. You can do that by clicking my unique link in the description below this video and follow me at Baus Phoenix. And now back to the topic at hand, the insect glaive. It's flashy, it's fun, and it's basically two weapons in one. You get the glaive, which is your spinny, hit-things stick, and you get the kinsect, a helpful little guy, good for smacking monsters in the face and grabbing buffs for you. The insect glaive boasts a fast attack speed and unparalleled mobility, and I feel like it's always been kind of a middle point between the longsword and the dual blade. So if you like either of those weapons, or if you like flipping around like a goddamn anime ninja, then this is the weapon for you. Now, originally, I was turned off by this weapon in the earlier games like 4U and Generations because there was this whole mechanic that revolved around you taking care of your kinsect, and if you messed up the progression of the kinsect, it basically resulted in a ruined weapon setup, and it just kind of seemed like more of a time investment than I was willing to make. In Monster Hunter World, though, many people are happy to know that the feeding mechanic has been removed, which has made the weapon a lot more accessible. But with the introductions out of the way, let's take a look at how to use this weapon. So starting off, like I mentioned earlier, the weapon is composed of two parts. We've got the glaive itself and the supporting kinsect. Now before we get into anything else, let's talk about how the kinsect works. If you notice, in the top left-hand corner of the screen, there are a few icons exclusive to this weapon. The bug icon represents your kinsect, and when he's gathered extract, the body will change color accordingly. Next to that, we have the diamonds with numbers in them, and these are your active buff slots. Each type of essence the kinsect harvests from a monster has a corresponding color and effect and is harvested from a different part of the monster. Red buff goes on the number 1 slot and gives you increased damage and unlocks more attacks in the glaive's moveset. Typically, you can harvest red buff from the head of a monster or any other parts that the monster uses to deal damage. This one is super important and you want to make sure you have it at all times. Remember, you are nothing without red buff. White buff increases your movement speed and goes in the number 2 slot. This is typically harvested from parts that allow the monster to move, which most commonly are his feet. Finally, orange buff goes in the number 3 spot and gives you resistance to being staggered while attacking. Be careful when using this one though, because it can be hard to remember that you're actually taking damage and you could wind up dead. But wait, there's more. Our fourth buff is the green buff. Your kinsect can't store green extract, but if you hit the monster in a certain spot, usually on the tip of the tail for most monsters, you will get a small heal, and you can see that by the little green burst that's coming off of me occasionally. Now, when you have all three buffs at the same time, not including the heal, of course, because it's instant and you can't store it, the effectiveness of each of the three buffs is increased. Some people call this Uber buff. Moving on, you can deploy your kinsect to harvest extract in one of three ways. Firstly, if you press the left trigger with your weapon out, you'll enter the aiming mode. From here, you can press triangle to send your kinsect out and he'll bump into the target to harvest the extract. This deals a little bit of damage, and while aiming, you can recall your kinsect by pressing circle, and this will give you whatever buff he's collected. Secondly, you can mark your target by firing a shot from your glaive by aiming with the left trigger and firing with the right trigger. This causes the Kinsect to attack that mark repeatedly until he runs out of stamina, as indicated by the little yellow bar under his icons. While doing so, he'll harvest extract, deal damage, and leave these clouds floating around that correspond to his dust effect. All Kinsects have a dust effect that corresponds to a different status ailment. There's paralysis, blast, poison, and healing. If you attack these clouds, they'll explode and deal status damage. Thirdly, for when you're up close and personal, you can deploy your Kinsect with a glaive attack by pressing R2. This acts as if you were to mark the target. That about covers the Kinsect side of the weapon though. For the glaive, it's a little more action-packed. Your attacks without red buff are pretty underwhelming, and they definitely won't pack as much punch. So, like I mentioned earlier, always make sure you have red buff ready to go. Now, most weapons have pretty straightforward attack patterns, but I found Insect Glaive to be a bit more free-flowing, and there aren't too many rules that'll restrict your combos. So let's take a look at a few of the things that you can do. In red buff mode, a triangle, triangle, circle is pretty much your bread and butter combo, and when you repeat it, it creates an infinite combo. This combo does have a few variations. If you want to initiate with a gap closer, you can do an inverted version of this combo by pressing forward plus circle, which lets you start with a leaping slash, and from there, you can chain into your triangle attacks. You can do this leaping slash at pretty much any point in your triangle chains, but you can't do it after the first attack in a circle chain or after a tornado slash attack. Also, a variation on this is the dodge slash, which you can do after any triangle attack by pressing back on the analog stick and circle. Now, if the opening to attack a monster is too small, you can start with a thrust attack, which is just forward and triangle, and that replaces your strong rising slash combo. Also, while in red buff mode, you get access to the tornado slash. This can be executed by pressing circle after the first or third attack in a chain, so it'll either be the second or fourth input in an attack chain if you want to think about it that way. Tornado slash is a nice little finisher that takes you right into your strong thrust, where you can repeat any of the above combos. And now for the fun part. To go airborne, execute a vault by pressing the right trigger and X at the same time. While in the air, there are three different things you can do. Pressing X while in midair will perform a midair evade. You can also do the midair evade by jumping from a ledge. Pressing triangle while in the air will perform a slam attack. Doing the slam attack will end any of your airborne follow-ups, so you can use this as a finisher. If you want to stay in the air though, pressing circle will perform the jumping advancing slash, and if you land the attack on a monster, you'll automatically vault again and can do another jumping advancing slash. You can do this as long as you have enough stamina. As you can imagine, these airborne attacks do massive mounting damage, and if you play your cards right, you'll be spending a lot of time on the back of monsters that you're fighting. To facilitate that, another tool in your arsenal is the unique mounted attack. When moving back and forth along the monster, you'll automatically attack while jumping from place to place instead of just moving. This is great for breaking those hard-to-reach back parts like the Wrath Carapace. So with the moveset out of the way, let's talk about the weapon tree and how upgrading works with the Insect Glaive. Being two parts of a weapon, you'll upgrade the Glaive and the Kinsect separately, but you should still take into consideration the stats of your Kinsect when selecting a Glaive or vice versa. Every Kinsect has three stats: power, speed, and heal. They also have an attack type, a dust effect, and later down the line, you'll unlock elements for them. For attack types, you have Sever and Blunt. Sever does cutting damage for severing tails, and Blunt does, well, it does blunt damage. And let me tell you, you have not lived until you've knocked a monster out with your Kinsect, because that is possible. The dust effect is the status cloud that your Kinsect produces when you mark the target. You've got poison, paralysis, blast, and heal. On the stats side, power is how much damage your Kinsect does, speed is how fast it flies and moves around, and heal is how much health you gain from green buff and your heal dust effect. When upgrading a Kinsect, make sure you plan ahead and carefully consider each upgrade lineage and what they offer, because once you've upgraded a Kinsect, you can't roll it back to an earlier version like you can with normal weapon upgrades. Don't fret though, if you mess up your Kinsect, just buy a new one from the smithy and start the upgrade over. Also, it's important to note that you'll most likely have many different Kinsects with different stats going into high rank. Since they're all good for different situations, it's not a bad idea to have a collection of kinsects to choose from. Lastly, you have the option of choosing an element for your kinsect, but note that as you will gain elemental attack power, the raw damage of your kinsect will go down. On the glaive side of things, you'll upgrade these like you would any other weapon. The only thing to take into consideration is the bonus your glaive gives to your kinsect. Try to pick one that complements your kinsect. Like, you wouldn't want a sever boost glaive with a kinsect that does blunt damage, or if you have a really high speed kinsect, you don't really need the speed boost buff. So in closing, while the insect glaive is a much more accessible weapon, I definitely wouldn't recommend it to newer players, because although it is very easy to pick up and swing around and it's fun and it looks pretty, it's a little tougher to master the deeper mechanics and plan out the development of your kinsects. Also, you're basically leveling two weapons at once, and that can really put a strain on resources if you're early into the game, and it makes progression feel a little slow. But overall, it is a fun weapon, and if you've been thinking about giving it a shot, I hope this video cleared up some questions or concerns for you. But that is about it, guys, and Jesus, that was a doozy of a video. Sorry it took me so long to get this one out. I spent two straight days writing and recording it, so I really hope it was helpful for you. If it was, leave a like down below, and if you're new here, get subscribed so that you never miss a new video. Until next time, though, I'm Balsphoenix. I'll see you at the next one, and as always, thank you so much for watching.